In the first video of the Amazon KDP keyword research tutorial series, I explained the keyword match types for e-commerce in detail. In this video, I will show you my favorite method for Amazon KDP keyword research. By learning this method, you can find many keywords with less competition for free. All you need is some time and patience. Let's get into this old but gold Amazon KDP keyword research method. By the way, don't forget to hit the subscribe button to get notifications when I upload more underrated methods for keyword research in this video series. Let's do it. As soon as the Amazon algorithm sees the first keystroke, it's ready with instant suggestions and a comprehensive set of search results. This feature is very helpful for customers but also sellers because it works like a real free Amazon keyword research tool. If you use it properly, I can say that it provides you with almost all the keywords necessary to put your title, subtitle, and backend keywords. First of all, before doing keyword research with Amazon auto-suggestion, either log out and clear your cache, or open Amazon in an incognito window to avoid any product suggestions that may come up from your previous searches. To browse in a new incognito window on Google Chrome, click on the three vertical dots in the upper right corner. Then choose New incognito window. Also, don't forget to enter a US zip code before starting if you are not in the US. Now, you are ready to gather auto-suggested keywords. In my previous videos, I demonstrated how to create lined pages and graph papers in Canva. Lined and graph paper notebooks are the most common low-content book niches for Amazon KDP beginners. However, they are both saturated. Let's check together if we can find low-competition keywords using my Amazon auto-suggestion method. Let's say you want to find low competition keywords for graph paper notebook on Amazon. To do this, you can use Amazon's auto-suggestion feature. When you start typing graph paper notebook in the Amazon search box, you will see a list of suggestions. These suggestions are actual queries that customers have used in the past to buy products on Amazon. They are called buyer keywords. Therefore, you should include related buyer keywords in your title and subtitle. However, keep in mind that when you do keyword research with Amazon auto-suggestion, you need to work systematically and patiently. Now, I can show you how I do it. First, take a screenshot of the auto-suggestions for your search term. Then, copy it to a spreadsheet and write down the relative keyword phrases with your book in the first column of the spreadsheet. Although we don't know the exact search volumes of these keywords, both search volumes and competition must be very high for them. Therefore, we should dig deeper to find low competition keywords. To discover low competition keyword ideas, append each letter of the alphabet to your search phrase. Each letter that you enter may return new suggestions of long tail keywords. So, let's start with letter A. Type graph paper notebook A into the search bar. If you receive new suggestions, take a screenshot and record the suggested keywords. Continue with the letter B. Type graph paper notebook B into the search bar. Again, if you get new suggestions, capture them in a screenshot and record them. But this is not enough to find long tail keywords with less competition. You need to spend more time and be patient. Let's take an example using the keyword phrase graph paper notebook 8.5 by 11. Capture a screenshot of any long tail keywords related to this phrase. Create a new column called long tail keywords and record these findings there. Keep going alphabetically by adding each letter to the end of the keyword phrase and check whether you can discover more long-tail keywords or not. Begin with the letter A as usual. Type graph paper notebook 8.5 by 11 A into the search bar. Take a screenshot and record the results. Continue with the letter B. Since spiral-bound notebooks are not available for Amazon KDP, we can skip these long-tail keywords. But if you check here, sometimes you might encounter long-tail keywords that don't start with your initial search term. Additionally, the suggested keywords may even end with your search term. If you watched the first video of this KDP keyword research series about keyword match types, Our goal was finding exact match search terms to use in our book titles and subtitles. This manual keyword research helps us understand how customers search for these products. You might stumble upon some low competition keywords you hadn't considered before. Once you have completed this process for all the keywords, it's time to check the search results pages for each one. This step will help us determine if we can effectively rank our books. For instance, if you check the search results of the keyword phrase graph paper notebook 8.5 by 11, you will find 2000 search results. However, when you check the search results of the keyword phrase graph paper notebook 8.5 by 11 4 squares per inch, there are only 382 search results. Many people say that if the search results are around 1000, it is a very good niche. But is it true? Well, it depends. We must consider several other factors on the search results page to determine whether it truly qualifies as a good niche. It doesn't mean that you can easily rank your book when you discover long-tail keywords with fewer search results like this one. In the final video of this Amazon KDP keyword research series, I will walk beginners through a case study on how to analyze search engine results pages. If you don't want to miss out, hit that subscribe button and turn on the notification bell. By doing this, you will get notified when I release a new video on underrated methods for KDP keyword research. Thanks for watching. See you soon.